Another one?
These never end.
For the love of God.
Who makes these things? This is unrelenting.
Oh, this is just brutal. Who does this stuff? You gotta write them a letter. I heard it's Fat Cat.
Care of Canada.
Care of Canada. This is a classic old school style Happy Tree Friends episode.
Just a fun ensemble of them being out camping.
Yeah, again, all the kids being taken care of.
I love how
by
stupid that bird looks, by the way.
It's a great bird.
Here's a nice fake out. Case got an axe. What's going to happen with the axe?
That's a great bird. Yeah. Flake?
Once again, Flakey's got good intentions.
They all do.
Even though Flakey's scared, Flakey's
trying to do the right thing.
Oh.
Now that's an old gag from the book, right?
Yeah, this was an old, the whole Flakey bit here was an old gag that was from the book that she was trying to save this little bird. And that's pretty much what happens. Oh, this is great. The
woodland cobra.
The elusive woodland cobra.
Very deadly. So what do you do when you set up camp? Shave.
Yeah, shave. You use up the water from the canteen.
Yeah, all the water. Even though there's tons of water behind you.
Yeah, but this is distilled water.
That's true.
Or rainwater.
Drinkable. Potable water.
It's Gatorade.
I like this little...
kids.
Oh, stupid kids. Put me in charge of
that. Leave him alone. And why he's wearing lederhosen? Because it's funny.
Yeah, it's hiking stuff.
Yeah. Exactly. That says hiking like lederhosen. Just always gets Venom's a big groan and then a big laugh.
That's what venom does. It drips out of the wound.
And everybody
this
knows you're sucking out.
This is a great gag. Just him spitting it out in the skull of his face.
Huge laugh when we show this to live audiences.
And then just complete chaos. Of course, in Happy Tree Friend style, it just goes from bad to worse to unimaginably worse.
Oh, and the brains coming up here.
This is great.
Is an invention of the storyboard artist, Tom Price, did this.
Fat Cat guys did a great job of the little fish coming in and out.
Yeah, trying to eat
really
the brain.
Great touch. Sequence.
Sniffles' mouth, by the way, if you notice, there's off.
He had it underneath his snout.
That was an art thing we didn't catch until, well, you later.
Until right now. That's awesome.
That's for you, all you...
Die
super
hard.
Happy True Friends fans out there.
We'll see you on the boards. We'll talk about it. Put that in the mistakes thread.
It's the only one, man.
That's it.
Is
it really a mistakes thread?
Oh, yeah. They point out all our mistakes. Thank you, by the way, for pointing out all our mistakes. We appreciate that.
This is a nice little hard cut.
You know she's thirsty, too, because she would normally never drink something that dirty. She has OCD.
Desperation.
Well, what's the order city of these episodes?
This was actually written before she had OCD.
That's true. This was...
But it still works.
Oh, yeah. Lippy.
You'll notice that, that he's wacky eye kind of randomly placed either on the right or the left side of his face.
Wait, that's not a mistake.
No, that's the magic of animation.
Intentionally do that.
Same with Lumpy's horns.
Don't touch that bird, Lumpy.
The bird is poison.
It's a trap. It's a bird trap.
It is. Everybody seems to know what's coming up here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that fake out of that shape that's similar to the bear in the back just doesn't seem to fool anybody.
No, we should have made the bear green.
Our audience is way too smart.
No, we're way too stupid.
That or that.
I like the flaky. Whoa. A little bit lower, they would have been revealing a little more than we wanted to see.
It's a classic cartoon gag of somebody getting sliced and running away, all sliced.
Look at it's all bounced.
Where's all the honey?
Maybe it's digested.
That's how quick his metabolism works.
It is. I love the legs.
Even though he's really fat from it.
You know what I love? I love that he picks them up.
Yeah.
Just
it's still
the bottom part.
It might not be all of him, but it's still him.
It's something to bring home to the family.
Exactly. Family needs to bury something. This is a nice little sequence of him pushing the thing and across this old rickety bridge and starting catching on fire from the friction.
What could go wrong?
Yeah, what could go wrong?
How did that happen?
Oh yeah, every rock to hit.
This is simple, but effective.
Yeah, you can feel all those hits, which is great. Ooh.
Some of those we should make into shirts.
Shorts?
Shirts, or shorts.
This is great. Lumpy grabs onto the line, thinking it'll save him, but it's too long!
Oh, what the?
But he's okay.
Lumpy's tough.
Spitting out a mouthful of bloody chiclets. You gotta love it.
That was a board gag, too, that Tom added.
Tom Price, ladies and gentlemen.
Do our storyboard artists don't think we're funny enough?
Clearly not.
No. Hey,
honestly, these guys need some help.
This whole sequence.
All right.
I'm gonna get in there and fix this whole mess. Yeah, this whole thing didn't make sense until Tom got to it. We just gave him like a page of
scratches. A page if they go camping, and that's all it said.
Actually, we said they go to the beach, and he didn't think it was particularly funny, so he came up with this camping show. God love him.
Animal mauling is always fun.
I remember we got this image back of Lumpy from Fat Cat and went, oh, okay. Yeah, they don't mind the gore.
I like the good bridge. The nice little bridge that the bear was going to go use.
A lot of people don't get that joke.
That there was a perfectly good bridge.
Yeah.
It grows on you. You have to watch it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we encourage everybody to watch these 20, 40, 60 times.
On brand new DVD.